Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep. In this video series, we are talking about indifference curve analysis for the advanced segment. In our previous video, we talked about how we could derive a demand curve for normal goods through PCC or price effect. This video shall focus upon derivation of demand curve for Giffen goods through PCC or price effect. So without wasting any time further, let's get started. Now, if some of you have landed on this video for the first time and have no idea about the law of demand, exceptions to the law of demand, indifference curve analysis, then it'll be better that you learn these segments first before you come onto this video, because it won't make any sense to you. The links for all the mentioned videos would be available in the description box. Let us see what are Giffen goods. So if you have studied law of demand and are aware about the exceptions to the law of demand, Giffen goods is one of the exceptions of the law. These are those goods which are generally considered as essentials, specifically by the low income group, like staple foods such as bread, rice, or potatoes. All right. Now, it's a rare type of a commodity in economics, and as I mentioned, it's an exception to the law of demand. It means that as the price of this Giffen good increases, the quantity demanded for Giffen goods would also go up. And as the price of Giffen good would fall, the quantity demanded of Giffen good would also fall. It violates the law of demand. So what are Giffen goods and why it violates the law of demand? So technically, when the price of a Giffen good rises, consumers with limited budgets would want to cut back on their consumption of more superior or expensive alternatives and would consume more of these Giffen goods so that their basic needs are met. All right. So that's why it is considered as an exception to the law of demand. Now let's take a look at how we could derive a demand curve through indifference curve analysis in case of Giffen goods. All right. So in this diagram, we have good Y on the Y axis, good X on the X axis. In our first panel, let me call it as panel Roman 1 and Roman 2. All right. So in panel 1, we have good Y on the Y axis, good X on the X axis. Now, which of these is a Giffen good? Good X is a Giffen good. Let me just jot that down. Giffen good. All right. So here also it is by default assumed that it is a Giffen good. Now in the second panel, we have price on the Y axis and quantity of this Giffen good, that is commodity X, on the X axis. AB is the budget line, IC is the initial indifference curve, and E is the point of equilibrium where consumer is consuming OX quantity of this Giffen good. Let us jot that down on the diagram below. Since we do not have exact numericals, we'll assume the prices for this segment. So let's plot this quantity X from panel 1 to panel 2. Let us say this is the initial quantity of commodity X consumed by the consumer, which is equivalent to OX. Now we are assuming that the price of this Giffen good is falling. Now we should know by now that when the price of a commodity falls, what will happen to the budget line? The budget line would rotate outwards. I didn't write rotate. Rotate outwards. Okay. Let's rotate the budget line outwards. Let us say this is AB1. Now we are assuming this particular scenario where price of a Giffen good falls and the quantity consumed by the consumer of this Giffen good also tends to fall. So on this new budget line, which is AB1, now if we make the indifference curve somewhere here, the consumer would end up consuming this much of commodity X, which is much greater than the earlier scenario. That means we cannot have an indifference curve here. Why? Because the quantity of this Giffen good consumed by the consumer is supposed to go down. That means it has to be somewhere in this region. All right. So let's make our indifference curve. Let us say this is IC1, this is E1, and in this particular scenario, this is the quantity consumed by the consumer. Let us call it OX1. Now, it is absolutely clear in this segment that the quantity consumed after the price of Giffen good fell has gone down from this to just this, right? Let's bring it down on the second panel to see what is happening with the price. Bring it down over here. This is OX1. Initially, the price was somewhere over here. And when price fell, let us put the price over here. So this is P1. And initial price is P. Now, when we join these pointers E and E1, we get a PCC curve which is backward bending. This is PCC. And when we join these two pointers in the lower panel or the second panel, we get a demand curve which is an upward sloping demand curve. This demand curve is an upward sloping demand curve indicating a positive relation between price and quantity demanded. This is how the demand curve for Giffen goods would be derived under the price effect or PCC method. I hope you understood this video. Children, if you find my videos useful, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Please share my videos with your friends as well. I had mentioned that I'll release the notes this weekend. I completely forgot that it is Diwali. So by next weekend, the notes for diminishing marginal utility would be released on my Facebook page. If you haven't followed me there, please go ahead and follow me there as well. All right, students, enjoy your festivities. Stay safe. Bye now. Take care.